Hi, everybody. This is Rob Mize with part two of the After Effects Waving Flag version 2.0. In part one, we went over the basics of creating our flag and introduced a couple of new elements and streamlined the process a bit. In part two, we'll add some enhancements to our project that will take our waving flag to the next level. So let's pick up where we left off in the first part of our tutorial. And let's begin by coming back to our adjustment layer and going into Distort and add a mesh warp effect. And this will add a mesh that allows us to change the shape of our layer here. I don't need this many rows and columns. I actually only need two rows and one column because I just want to grab this point over here at the left and bring it forward some to just give us a sense of tension on our flag that would be created by the wind. I also want to make this adjustment. You see, you can adjust that just as you would any other Bezier curve. And I think I'll also grab these points here on the right side. I'll shift-click all three of these to select them all, and I'll bring that down just to give a sense of weight to our flag. Now, the big enhancement that we've added here is furl, and that is for this edge on the right to be blown back over or behind the other portion of the flag. I'll show you what I mean. Let's choose our flag and select Distort CC Page Turn. And immediately you can see what's happening here. Now our flag is being blown back over itself, as it might be on an actual windy day. I'll change fold direction to minus 90 here. And we can animate this by hand, certainly. We can keyframe this, but we can also use expressions to do this for us. So if I consider how far I want this flag to fold over, let's say that's the maximum I want this fold to come back. And if I come back about the halfway point, I'm going to establish that as the starting point for my expression. The same with the fold direction. I want this straight part, this 90-degree angle, to be the starting point for an expression we'll add there. So let's Alt-click Fold Position. And we only want this expression to affect the x-axis. So I'll type W equals wiggle, open parentheses, 0.25, comma, 250, close parentheses, semicolon. Return to go to a new line. Type open bracket, W, open bracket, 0, close bracket, comma, value, open bracket, 1, close bracket, close bracket. And what this is saying is that W equals the wiggle expression that we will get a quarter of a wiggle every second with an amplitude of 250 pixels. The second line tells us that the wiggle expression applies to the value 0, which corresponds to the x-axis. The value of the y-axis, which is indicated by the bracketed 1, is going to remain the same. It will be unchanged. It will retain its value. And so the result of our expression is our flag kind of flapping back and forth in a random manner. Now this fold position, we don't want it to remain just at minus 90, so let's add an expression there. Again, Alt-click the stopwatch, and I'll type wiggle, open parentheses, 0.25, comma, and let's make this, let's say, about 45 degrees, close parentheses. Now, not only our fold position, but also our fold direction is animating by means of this expression. Now, let's make a couple of adjustments here on this page turn. First of all, we need to bring our back opacity up to 100%. I'm going to change this fold radius. I want it up quite a bit. Let's go ahead and leave it there at about 95. So let's copy our page turn effect using Command-C and come up to our displacement map and paste it using Command-V. And if we hit U, we see that we have the same expression driving the displacement map. However, it's not matching up. Why not? Because wiggle expressions create random values, and these random values aren't necessarily going to match each other. So how do we resolve that? Well, we'll replace this current expression with another one, a very simple one that we create just by pick whipping fold position of our displacement layer to fold position of our flag. And we'll do the same for fold direction. Now the displacement gets its positioning from the flag layer. We do need to make an adjustment here on displacement map. We want the back page to be the displacement map, not the flag layer, so that when this flips around, we'll also have the displacement map highlighting the back of our flag there, like so. Now, there's one other thing I want to do to give an extra dimension to this. I want to create some separation between this back part of the flag and the front part of the flag. So I'll duplicate this flag layer, and I'll call this part flag back. Our original layer I'll call flag front. Let me make some adjustments here. I want flag front to only render the front page. I want flag back to only render the back page. And we see that the front and back aren't matching up. If we hit U and see our page turn effect, we see that we need to once again pick whip the values of the flag back to the page turn values of the flag front. Now all of these layers get their motion from the flag front. And let's go ahead and parent that flag back here. Okay, let's duplicate the flag back. And I'm going to call this shadow. And bring it beneath the flag back so that it's between the front and back layers. So let's go on this shadow layer, and we can get rid of this bevel edges effect. But let's add a perspective drop shadow effect. And let's make this shadow only. And figure out where we're going to place it. Adjust this around. I don't want that much distance between it, so I'll bring that back some. And I'll soften it quite a bit because I really just want a hint of that shadow there. But I think it's enough to give us a sense of extra separation between these two layers. If we look at it without it and with it, I think we get something from that. I also want to come up to this flag back and take off this bevel edges effect because it just doesn't work right with this page turn. Instead, I'm going to come down here and use a perspective bevel alpha effect. And you see, once again, we get just a hint of thickness there to the edge of our flag. Now, for another dimension to this, we realize that sometimes the flag flaps behind the flag front. It doesn't always curl in front of it. So how can we do that? Well, to make this point more evident, I'm going to turn off these expressions. And let's just adjust this by hand to bring this back. And I'm going to bring this fold direction down about so. And in fact, I'm going to scale this down a little bit more so we can make this point more clearly. Now, to make this flag fold go behind our flag, let's select all these layers and make them 3D. And hit P to reveal the position parameters. And we see that they're all in zero position in Z space. To get this flag back to go behind the flag front, let's start by adding a position keyframe and use Alt-Command-Click to make it a hold keyframe. That way that value will stay the same until it encounters another keyframe of a different value. Now, to get our flag behind the flag front, let's change this value to 1 and move it back 1 pixel in Z space. Let's add a position keyframe to our shadow. Again, Alt-Command-Click to make it a hold keyframe. And let's change this to a value of 0.5. Now, our shadow is between the flag back and the flag front. But we see our displacement layer is causing a bit of artifacting here. And the way we'll deal with that is let's go to our displacement layer page turn effect. And here on render, let's add a keyframe there. Hit U to reveal it. And let's just go ahead and drag this to match up with the other keyframes. And now let's change it to render front page only. So there is our flag. With all these position values at 0, it is in front of our flag. With these new keyframes that we just added, it goes behind our flag. Now, if we want to see that animation, let's animate this fold flag position. Let's open up our effect there. And let's add a keyframe for fold position and bring that forward. And let's change this position to unfolded. And we'll bring that back a little bit. So as our fold begins, just as it starts coming in front of our flag front, just as it starts to fold over, right before that, I'm going to bring these keyframes to this position, just where it starts to fold. So instead of folding over, it's going to fold behind. And if we bring our fold position back to where it was, let's bring our flag back position to 0, our flag shadow position back to 0, and our displacement layer back to front and back page. And now when our flag folds back, it will be in front of our layer. And so we have something like this. Flag begins to fold. The positions change to move it back behind the flag front in Z space. It unfolds, and our positions change to bring it in front of our layer in Z space. Now, I was thinking how I could share these particular settings on these effects, since I can't send you the actual After Effects files. So the way I'll do this is I'll choose all these layers and hit U to reveal the changes that we've made on all these effects. And if I hit the accent or the tilde key, that is the key next to the number one key, it will bring that particular window to the full screen. So here are the effects and the settings that I used on the flag pre-comp. And if you don't see a certain parameter up here, it means that it has not been changed. That parameter is still in its default position. So you can either pause the tutorial at this point or grab a screen capture, whatever will work best for you if you want to look at these settings in greater detail. On the displacement map, these are the effects and settings that I had on the displacement map. And finally, on our waving flag, these are the effects and the settings that we use there. I'll scroll up a little bit so you can see all of those layers that we have there. So here in my final comp, which is 1920 by 1080, I've added my waving flag comp. I've positioned and scaled it as I need it. My flagpole is just a couple of shape layers with a gradient fill to give it a sense of shape. And the line is also a shape layer with no fill and just a slight stroke. And I've added that to this JPEG of the White House. And I've used CC Particle World to create my fountain. In order to add a camera move, all these layers are set to 3D, except for the fountain, because CC Particle World is inherently 3D. And another thing, on this flag layer, since all these are 3D, we can grab this anchor point, I'll hit the Y key, and I'll drag this over here to the left edge of our flag composition. And now, we see that we can also rotate this on the Y axis as well. So we can add another dimension of animation to our waving flag. So there you have it, your own customized banner, ready to stake your claim to whatever territory your heart desires, and long may she proudly wave. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and will come back to see what else we're working on. I'm always interested in your ideas and suggestions and how you've put these techniques to work. So until next time, this is Rob Mize wishing you happy compositing.